In this lecture, we are going to discuss data warehousing on AWS. The content covered in this lecture is primarily inspired by a white paper published by AWS. It's called Data Warehousing on AWS. Let's start with a typical flow with data warehousing. Data typically flows into a data warehouse from transactional systems and other databases. This includes structured, semi-structured, and unstructured data. This data is processed, transformed, and ingested in regular intervals. Users, including the data scientist, business analyst, and other decision makers, they access the data through BI tools, SQL clients, etc. A dedicated data warehouse is needed for multiple reasons. This helps in data consolidation so that you can get the cross-system data insights. A typical data warehouse employs ETL processes to clean and standardize the data. This improves the accuracy, consistency, and the overall quality of data. It also helps in segregating the analytics workloads from the operational workloads. And this ensures both transactional as well as the analytics systems are delivering the expected performance. To enable data insights with data warehousing, we must have an efficient analytics pipeline. The modern analytics pipeline can be broken down into four main stages. Collect data, which helps in gathering the diverse types of data across the enterprise. The data then gets processed either through the batch or the real-time workflows. The data must be stored. Typically, this is the processed data, but this could be raw data as well. Once the data is curated, we can analyze the data through analysis and visualization tools. For the data collection, most often we need to deal with a variety of sources. Typically, the data comes from transactional stores, which could be relational databases, technologies like MySQL, PostgreSQL, Oracle, etc. Or it could be based on NoSQL technologies like DynamoDB, MongoDB, etc. We might have the sources which are streaming the data. This could come through the streaming frameworks like Apache Kafka, Amazon Kinesis, etc. Or we might have the streaming data originating through Lambda, DynamoDB, S3, events, etc. We could be dealing with the application log data as well, which is getting stored on S3 or the file systems. The data processing stage is where the raw data is transformed into the actionable insights. During this stage, you can process the data in either of the two modes, batch processing or real-time processing. Batch processing can further be segregated into three different areas, ETL, ELT, and OLAP. Let's understand these processes quickly. ETL is normally a continuous ongoing process with a well-defined workflow. During this process, data is initially extracted from one or more sources. The extracted data is then cleansed, enriched, transformed, and then loaded into the data warehouse. On AWS, most of the ETL processes will be performed outside of the data warehouse with tools such as AWS Glue, Apache Spark, or Apache Hive on AWS EMR. ELT is a variant of ETL where the extracted data is loaded into the target system first. Transformations are performed after the data is loaded into the data warehouse. ELT typically works well when your target system is powerful enough to handle the transformations. Amazon Redshift can be used for the ELT pipelines because it is highly efficient in performing the transformations. OLAP systems store aggregated data in multi-dimensional schemas. OLAP systems enable you to extract data and spot trends on multiple dimensions. As Redshift is optimized for the joins across different data sets, Redshift can be used to build the OLAP systems for you. As discussed earlier, Amazon Kinesis Services and Amazon MSK, which is the managed services for Apache Kafka, can be used to capture and store the streaming data on AWS. You can process this data sequentially and incrementally on a record-by-record basis or over the sliding time windows. You can use a variety of technologies to process this data, including AWS Lambda, Amazon Kinesis Client Library, Kinesis Data Firehose, and AWS Glue Streaming Jobs. You can also use MSK to process the data. Analytics derived from real-time processing is called as real-time analytics. There are many use cases for it. This can be used to track customer activity, let's say for a fraud detection, or to track the IoT devices for failures, unusual activities, etc. With real-time analytics, you can act or respond promptly to a specific situation. The most important stage in analytics pipeline is to store the data for analytics. There are three different architectural patterns in the modern analytics: lakehouse, data warehouse, and data mart. Let's quickly check them out. Data warehouse is the most adopted pattern to store the data for analytics. Data warehouses generally employ the denormalized schemas like star schema and snowflake schema. Users or systems consume the data from data warehouse using the SQL queries, which can then be represented in reports, dashboards, etc. A data mart is a simple form of data warehouse focused on a specific functional area or a subject matter. For example, if there is a retail company, we can have a specific data mart for e-commerce store and another data mart for the physical store. In this case, the data storage and data consumption happen similar to the data warehouse, but querying across functional areas can become a bit complex as the data marts are distributed in any given enterprise. A lakehouse is an architectural pattern that combines the elements of data warehouses and the data lakes. Lakehouses enable you to query data across your data warehouses, data lake, and even the operational databases. You can use Amazon Redshift to build all these storage architectures, including data warehouses, data marts, and lakehouses. The last stage in the analytic pipeline is to analyze and visualize the data. You can use any SQL client such as MySQL Workbench to analyze your data in Redshift with SQL. Redshift also works well with popular third-party BI tools available on the market such as Tableau and MicroStrategy. Amazon QuickSight is the AWS native tool that enables to create visualizations and perform the data analysis for you. With this, we covered all the stages for a modern-day analytics pipeline. Please note that pipeline and the technologies we discussed here are related to data warehousing on AWS only. It does not touch other key areas in analytics such as data lake and machine learning.